Hi guys, welcome to my channel. So while I was walking on my way from Ongatarongai to Nairobi City, I came across these baboons by the side of the road. Now I am told they like to stick around here by the side of the road because while people are in traffic from Nairobi City going towards Ongatarongai, they always like to throw junk food that they bought in town by this side of the road at this point. So they come here because they like to come and collect the dropped junk foods and containers and everything, including yogurt and many other fruits, so that they can eat or lick or enjoy themselves. So I thought this was amazing and I decided, no, I'm going to record this, because especially this baboon, this one right here, it was licking its hands like a human being. Just look at it. This is so amazing. It's definitely licking its hands and fingers for yogurt. Dipping the hands in the fingers inside the yogurt can, then licking it. This was so amazing. I decided, no, I really must have to get this on camera. Guys, I do many YouTube videos like this one, amazing like this one. So please like and subscribe. If you are new, make sure you subscribe. Please like. Liking is very important. YouTube recommends my videos to many other people based on how much it's liked. So when you like my video, someone else is likely to watch my videos too because of you. And this way you are supporting me. Currently, I am currently just struggling to survive on this YouTube. I'm not even monetized. So when you watch a lot of my videos, I can get monetized. So please support me. Just be sure to like and subscribe. Thank you. So this, I thought this is beautiful and amazing. So I thought to myself, well, these baboon families, you know, the reason why they are here in the first place is because Nairobi is the first city and capital city with a national park in it. You can Google that actually right now, even on YouTube. You will see what I'm saying is very true. Nairobi is the only city with a national park in it. So these monkeys, they just cross over from the park. The park's fence is right there. Let me see. You see that green lining? That's where the park starts, going right there. And where I'm standing right behind me, it's the highway. So when they usually like to come here because they lick things that have been dropped off, most of the time junk food and fruits. I thought this was a very beautiful baboon family. They are so fat, so huge and fluffy, and they are so peaceful, and they cuddle and they love each other and they play with the kids. Just look at this. So I thought I have to get this on camera. And sometimes I just sit and think, while these baboons, you know, they are an endangered species. If we don't take care of them, actually, one by one they start going extinct. And sooner or later, generations to come will not get to see a baboon. They just see them on videos like these ones, or read them on books, or see the pictures, but they will not get to see them. And this is very sad. This is how so many of our animals have gone extinct in the world. Because we don't take good care of them. Because we actually don't take that. We don't pay attention to these animals. And these animals, they are not blessed. They are not actually blessed with us. No, we are blessed as humans to have that critical thinking and to work and do things and to innovate. And actually, we were so much blessed. But for them, they actually depend on us. If we can't protect them, if we can't look after them, if we can't always value their presence in this world, one by one we always lose them and they can become extinct. Just look at this teen baboon. It's actually licking the straw. This straw was used to drink the yogurt, the other one was licking. So the straw also has some yogurt juice. So it decided, no, let me lick this straw and get some juice. So you see, this is the road, the other side is development. This side is the national park. Kenya, we are blessed with too many things you can do in Kenya when you visit. So if you are thinking Corona is good to travel and you are planning maybe for Corona you can travel, Kenya is one place you should consider. we have some other good things like in Samara. You can go see the Elvis migration. It's always, I think, in June and July period. You can Google actually just to be accurate. It's a very beautiful thing, many people come to see it. We also have a very long coastal line where you can go and sit in the white and blues and beaches, great hotels and everything. But my favorite is the safaris. You can do the safaris. Even when you land to Nairobi, in Nairobi city, you don't have to travel very far. Nairobi National Park is just right by the city. You go and see elephants, lions, the big five. You can see many, many birds and many, many other wild animals. But right back to my topic, I think this baboon family is a very beautiful thing. You see, it wasn't even afraid of me or my presence. So they were not even, they didn't even take note of my presence. Like, they just exist. They are very peaceful. They are not aggressive. They just want to eat whatever is left. That is their main agenda here. Look at this one. Just picking things and eating. It's very fluffy and very fat. You can see it likes eating. This is why it's very fluffy like this. It needs to hit the gym. But I think it must be the leader. When they travel in these parks, there's always the alpha. I don't know if that's the right name, but there's always the alpha. It is the largest and the male one. Then there are females and uncles. It's an extended family of kids and everything. They just exist and they are happy. I love this so much. So guys, my main point here is we should cherish these wild animals when we still have them. Sooner or later, I know many of them are going to go extinct if we don't take a step back and say no, we have to start taking good care of them. We have to protect them. We have to understand that the environment also has to be protected. These national parks that were developed in Kenya, they are a very good thing because they clearly stipulate the line between animals and people, so that we can't build into the national parks. And also they try to stay in the national parks, they can't come into the civilian population. And this is very okay because it helps these wild animals and these beautiful creatures to coexist with human life. You know? Just look at this family, so peaceful. And they are very healthy. You can just tell they are very healthy. It can sit down, just eating, singing, looking at people, and cars passing. This is very, very beautiful. Guys, thank you for watching, and please, 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 I would like to reiterate again. Please. Like my videos. When you like my videos, many people get to watch it. And when many people watch my videos, YouTube may one day start to pay me. And that will be a good thing because I want to show many, many videos of these beautiful creatures and wild animals and everything, including giraffes and the big five and everything. So please, guys, like and subscribe. I also want to market my country, Kenya. I love Kenya so much and I want many people to come and see these wild animals. Because it creates jobs for us locals. It gives us jobs and forex exchange. So, thank you guys. Look at how much it is. Please like and subscribe.